And it's true, especially when it comes to our home. And boy, we've got a lot of heart in Fleetwood Port Kells. You know, I see it go by almost on a daily, weekly basis. And so the other day, you know, when, for instance, we heard from Narima De La Cruz about a fundraiser that the Filipino community was putting on to send support back to the Philippines, who got hammered with two typhoons within a week. And the number of homeless people and the degree of suffering down there is just staggering. And the Filipino community here in Canada is answering that cause. I'll have more to say on that in a few minutes. And there are other things that I see go by too. And I saw one earlier in the week and I thought, doggone it, we got to talk about that. There's a group of our neighbors throwing their support behind a plan to upgrade the playground equipment at William Watson School. That's on 80th near 164th. It's one of the oldest schools, as you'll hear, in Surrey. And some of their playground equipment is old and probably isn't as safe as it needs to be, so it has to be replaced. Well, this is where we enter the world of the Parent Advisory Committees, the PACs. I think just about every school, especially the elementary schools, have very important people who do very important things on their PACs. And the picture that I saw was from a lady who is part of the PAC at William Watson, Rebecca Paul. We caught up with her to find out what she and the William Watson PAC have been up to make better this playground. And it's really quite an undertaking. Have a listen.
So first of all, thanks for having me on. But second of all, it is a wonderful school. Both of my kids have gone there since kindergarten. It is one of the oldest schools in Surrey, built in 1959. And it has the only 400 meter track in all of Surrey. And as you know, Surrey is just exploding, particularly Fleetwood. So this school has a lot of kids going to it, and a lot of the playground is really, really old. Two pieces in particular are deemed to be removed in 2021 by the district. And we have been fundraising like nobody's business to try to get new equipment in there. So far, we've raised $35,000.
Wow.
Right. So we're very excited about that. But we've got about 10,000 more that we really need to raise. And we're going to the community, all the businesses in the community, and looking for donations. I know it's the end of the year, so a lot of corporations have money out there. We're really hoping that they'll think about us, the little school that could, and help us get this done. You know what? Our entire school is just such a community-based school. We have probably about 20 really serious full-time volunteers that help out. And then the community kind of comes in and helps. We've got a school-wide bottle fundraiser going on right now, where actually all of the local bottle depots have given us over 400 labels. And we've given bags out to all of the parents at the school to take bags in. Every little bit helps. Purdy's for Christmas, you know, it's been pretty special. If anybody wants to give their donations in terms of bottles in, you know, a return to the bottle depot, we have our William Watson bottle depot set up as well. And so that would be, all they have to do is really enter a phone number, which is 604-574-4141. And then the bottle deposit goes directly to us. There's one swing set that's being removed that's going to be replaced with just an exact replica, but obviously one that's new. But the really exciting piece is actually this piece it's for the intermediate kids. So it has to be geared towards, you know, stuff that they would use, not so much, you know, the smaller kids use a lot of the different equipment, but this has to be specific to them. So the one that we're particularly interested in, Ken, is a piece that has the ability to do arm bells, and it has the ability to do a little bit more gymnastics type stuff. And it, like, even people that come to use the track, because the entire community uses this school track, it's, you know, it's a very popular space for people to use, just because, you know, adults can go there and use it at night. So this particular piece could potentially be used even by adults as almost like, exercise equipment, because there's dumbbells and there's climbing apparatus and there's different aspects to it. We're pretty excited about it. I mean, I sort of want to be an older lady and be able to go down there and say that I was part of something that tried to help a school that, you know, public school, what can you say? And, you know, private schools, you have people that will spend $100,000, you know, for a front parking spot, you know, but public schools just don't get that kind of interest. So, you know, to be able to have the community come out and do any kind of supporting of this is pretty special.